With 555 cases confirmed across the country, this year now has the second highest number of measles cases in the United States in 25 years, and the year isn't even half over. Dr. Pauline Rolle joins us this morning. She is the medical director with the Duval County Health Department. Good morning. Thank you for being here. You were just here last week, and we were talking about measles. Since then, I think we've now seen another 100 cases just in the last week across the country. I want to start first, and ask you specifically about Duval County. Is there any reason that people here, not just in our county, and I know that you're in contact with health departments around the area, but Northeast Florida and even Southeast Georgia, any kind of concern about a measles outbreak at all?
Well, our epidemiology department continues to do surveillance to monitor what's happening in our county as well as around our county. Fortunately, we have high vaccination rates here in Florida, and so we have not seen the same impact that other states have had. But we live in a global society. People travel constantly, and so we're not without risk.
So last time you were here, you mentioned something that I'd like to pick up on and expound on a little bit more this morning. There tends to be this theory among parents, that, well, measles, fever, rash eventually goes away. There are some long-term effects, are there not, associated with the measles infection, as we're seeing now with this flight attendant who's now in a coma because she caught it on a plane from somebody who was infected from New York?
Yes. I think because the majority of people recover, parents are not taking this seriously. But there are those who have what is called encephalitis, swelling of the brain, and it can occur within the immediacy of getting the measles disease, but it can also happen 7 to 10 years later. You're fine, you've recovered, and now this happens. And sometimes people don't always make that connection, but that is indeed a risk of getting the measles disease.
I believe I also read a statistic, in fact, it was just yesterday. Is there an increased risk if you're infected with the measles of developing pneumonia too?
Yes, there is. Yes, because your immune system takes a hit. And so you're more likely to have other infections, such as pneumonia. So unfortunately, people still die of pneumonia. And so that is indeed a risk. And we also must think of those who cannot be vaccinated. You have to keep in mind, that vaccine starts at 12 months of age. And so for those babies who cannot be vaccinated, we're also trying to protect them. So it's not just about me getting measles, it's also about my community getting measles.
You know, I remember when I heard just last night, in fact, about this flight attendant who was infected, I immediately thought, gosh, as a flight attendant, you're flying all over, you're exposed to so many different people from different countries, you'd think that you would have been vaccinated. While we don't have any details about that flight attendant's, history, is this maybe we need to, as adults, have conversations with our parents or, about whether or not we were vaccinated when we were children?
Many people assumed they were vaccinated, and most of us were. So, yes, that's an important question to ask your parents. But also, if you're concerned about your immunity, talk to your physician. There are laboratory tests that can be done to determine your level of immunity and where you are. But certainly, talk to your parents first if they're still available. I still have my vaccination records from when I was a kid. My mom is good about keeping those records, so I have my records. But not all adults have those records, and so it's important to have those conversations.
Yeah, and the best way to prevent measles, of course, is vaccination. We can't say that enough, Dr. Rolle. Thank you for being here. Do appreciate it. Great information.